So we are live on the cable car, on the Titlis cable car to the summit of Turnpoint 7. We have been chasing Chrigel Maurer. I've been chasing Chrigel Maurer all day and I keep missing him. It's not the first time that he's done it. Remember the first time he did the race back in 2009, he actually beat the organisers to Monaco. There he got there and there was no one to greet him, and he seems to be doing it again. It's just extraordinary how quick he is up in the air today. He's flying unbelievably efficiently and it's just a joy to watch. If you get a chance, watch his next flight on live tracking. Now, I'm a little bit out of breath, I'm a bit overexcited, a little bit flustered because we just bolted from Davos to try and get here. We're on the last cable car. In fact, we're not even the last cable car left at 5 o'clock. But thanks to the man from Titlis Tourism, Moses here. He parted the waters. He made things happen like his namesake. And thanks to him, we are up here and it's just the most incredible view. So look over here. We got the lakeside over here. What's the name of the lake?
Trübsee.
Again, one more time?
Trübsee.
Yeah. And just over the peaks here, it's just incredible. Well, let's turn around again. And so up on the top there, somewhere, hopefully, still waiting for us at the top, is Mr. Maurer himself. But he's not going to hang around because from, I believe, just after 5 o'clock, the airspace opens up. So he is now free to fly to the Eiger. And it'll be amazing if he can tag three turn points in a day, but it's possible. It's possible that he could make the Eiger as well today. I mean, what is it? It's 10 to 6 now. We've got flying until 9 p.m. It's an incredible race. And just behind him, we've got Maxime Pinot, this heroic Frenchman who's extraordinary performance for first time in the Red Bull X-Alps, even though he's obviously extremely experienced adventurer and paraglider. And back in the pack, we've got the others following through, but this is where it's at. And let me tell you, if we manage to get to see Chrigel at the top, it will make me very happy, but he will have taken off already. It's just an extraordinary race this year. So unbelievably fast. Can anything slow this man down? It appears not. So we should be reaching the top in the next 5 or so minutes. So stay with us. We're going to come out the top and we're going to come out running and to look for Chrigel. It is the highest turn point in the race. It is 3,200 meters, is that right?
Yeah, exactly.
200 meters.
Yeah.
Now, on a day like today, obviously, great, you know, if you can fly here, but I believe that the weather's looking like it could turn in the next day or so, and if they can't fly, it is a brutal hike. Can you explain a little bit about the route that they have to take if they're hiking up? They have to cross two glaciers, is that right?
Yeah, exactly. They might have some problems here. You can see even here the path up here on the left. There it is, like a big glacier in front of here on the left. You see, it's called the Old Dusley. And it's pretty crazy, so they have to run up with all the gear and then to the tower. There is a turn point, the big tower, right? Over there.
So we can see the hanging glacier there, the little bit of Sirac fall up there. Is avalanche a little bit of a worry up here or not?
No,
so
not
much?
This time, yeah, not this time.
Yeah.
Not this time of the year.
But it must be an amazing ski area.
Yeah, it is amazing. It is unbelievable good, and I'm happy to grown up here, actually.
I'm sure. And besides paragliding, yeah. What adventure sports?
You can do climbing, hiking, biking. You can do probably everything, whatever you want to.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Wow. So let's have a look at your comments. So I'm just going to pass the phone. So if you've got any, comments, send them over. So someone just saying we need an extra team to follow the Eagle. We don't need an extra team. We need. It's just impossible. Extra teams. We need. Yeah, it's a challenge. It's to keep up with Chrigel Maurer, and it also shows just the beauty of the flying here in the Alps. You can take literally a bird's line across these mountains, and for the athletes taking part. That is largely the appeal of this race. You're just being able to soar over the mountains and cover incredible distances. And I've been talking to a few paragliding experts. I won't profess to be one myself, but I was speaking to a few paragliders, and they were looking at Chrigel's track earlier today and just saying he is flying with incredible efficiency. He's, you know, normal paragliders will be soaring, they'll be going round and round, you know, trying to kind of thermal like this. And Chrigel's doing something quite different. What he's doing is really taking a straight line approach and just looking for where he can get lift without circling. You know, he's often said in the past that, you know, when you're circling, you're kind of going backwards, and you don't want to be doing that in a race. So, I mean, what I love about Chrigel is this sort of modesty. You know, you ask him at the beginning and he says, no, for me, it's not so important to be first. I'm just doing it for the adventure. The adventure is for me. And, you know, he arrives at these turn points. And I don't know if you get a real feel for that, but he arrives and he's kind of fully... We've got to get out and change.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, it's going to get exciting now because we've got to get out and change. So I'm going to put the phone in. If we cut out, I will come back in again. Says, could you do that rucksack up? There's a strap that goes over the top.
Yep.
Great. I'll grab something as well. Got my roll mat, because I think we're going to spend a night up the top here. Just a little check around.
Yep.
So here we go. So this is my amazing... Through here. Whoop, steady. Round we go.
I can take
it's all right. We got it.
Okay.
We didn't have much time to change in the car, so we just brought everything that we could, like bags of food, sleeping bag. I've got... no, it's great. I've got... So we're here, look, here's the cable car. Here we are. We're still rolling. We've got one last little journey to go. Can I do that? Here we go.
Too speed,
he's gone.
He's landed already.
Is he still there?
Oh. There we go.
Yeah. Aha. Yeah.
Can I press the button?
Yeah.
Which one do I press?
Wait for it. Now we have to. Now you can do here. This phone here.
This one.
Yeah. Long. I'll just do that. That one.
You do it.
Woo!
Okay, are we rolling? Let's get a jacket out. I better get some kit on. And something else I haven't got. Yeah, look, I've got my... Got my supper for tonight. What have we got? We've got pork. I think it's pork and lentils. There we go. So a bit of food and a bottle of water. Right, so one more transition to do. The adventure of by car, by Audi e-tron, KB car, and any second we're gonna take off. But just in the meantime, check out the view.
Hope you have a jacket.
Yeah, we've got a jacket. Okay, thank you. Let's just put that on.
Now we're on.
Thank you. Let's get my warm jacket. Thank you very much. Oh, great. Can you be mother? Can you do the zip up? There we go.
Thank you. Yeah. Everyone needs a supporter. Very important.
Is he still off there?
Thank you. Thank you very much to my supporter, Sarah. Well done. She's been helping me with the driving. I think she's probably more exhausted than I am. But look, and just look at some of the views over here. It's just amazing.
Wow.
We've got the lake. Just beautiful. So what do you think? Do you think we'll get Chrigel? Do you think we'll get a chance to find him? Or do you think we'll have already flown the nest? Send me your comments. He's still waiting for you, Harry. We're trying, we're going as fast as we possibly can. I'm just gonna get out and run like crazy. What do you reckon, Moses? Do you think we'll get him?
I hope so, I hope badly, but yeah, we will see. I think it's pretty hard to catch him, but maybe we're lucky.
Yeah. Yeah, this is Switzerland, someone is saying. Yeah, this is cable car, super efficient. Hey, good morning, we've got someone from California watching. Go, 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 go. Maybe one of these buttons makes it go faster. Should I press one of these? This?
For sure not the minus there.
Look, check out this CIRAC here. So you can see why organisers were very concerned about the safety here. We've got, do we have crevasses here?
Yes.
You can just see the crevasse field just over here, and you don't want to fall in one of those. Look at that ice there. That's proper hardcore, as they say in Britain. So Moses, am I right in saying that they have to hike up from this side?
Exactly, they have to hike up from this side.
So if you're not able to fly, it's a hell of a long walk. It's about 10 kilometers?
Probably more or less, exactly.
Yeah.
And the tube says 1,800, and you have to go up to 3,000, so it's pretty tiring.
Yeah, so if you've just tuned in and wondering what's happening, the fact that we're inside a cable car, we have raced here all the way from Davos in the Audi e-tron. I have to say, it didn't need, we left with a 70% charge, not even on full charge, and we got here no problems at all. The only issue was traffic. But that and the incredible speed of Mr. Chrigel Maurer, the five-time champion in this race. And we are any moment about to come into the station. I'm just going to turn the camera around because that view is to die for. So, look at that. Isn't this Turnpoint the most amazing? Here we go, we're coming in.
On the left, then.
So where do I go for the Turnpoint?
Here on the left, and then up. Up the stairs, like on the very last floor.
So out of the left, right.
Yeah, exactly.
So, and I have to run up some stairs?
Yeah.
Okay.
If you want to, you can also take the elevator.
No, I'll run, it'll be quicker.
Yeah.
So all the way to the top?
Yes.
Okay. Wish me luck. We're going in. So there are the stairs, is that the stairs there? Okay. Might be a bit chilly out. Okay, we're going. Go.
Yeah.
Stand clear of the doors.
Stand clear of the doors. We're still rolling.
Okay.
Come on, on your marks. Are you ready? Let's go.
Okay, now we can run.
Okay, go. Here we go. Here's the view. And top.
Up.
All the way. All the way to the top.
Yeah.
Okay, we go. We go. We gotta go. Come on. Let's go. Good. Hard work. Come on. We can do this. And then left, there's a platform. Is he still? Oh, look. Look who we found. There he is.
So
there he is.
A Tarquin.
We found him. How are you?
Take care. Running in 3,000 meters is hard.
Yeah.
Can feel the thin air.
Can we just have a big...
Hey, Moses.
Yeah,
you're crazy.
We did it. We found you. We caught up with you. You're doing amazing. Tell us about that flight.
Another magic move. Yeah, it was the first step was to find the takeoff in Davos, where it could go very low, but for sure uphill.
Yeah, we saw you. You just went halfway up the mountain
and
took off.
It was working well. And then in the area between, the wind was headwind, and it was quite hard to continue, but there was fighting. And on the end, I had a very high base and not so much wind, so the wind decreased and comes more from the south. So it was possible to come here, and on the end, it was very, very weak, but I took the risk for the south face, because normally if I fly in the south and it's not climbing, I'm stuck in a big shit, because it's not possible to climb the Titlis from the south. And I was pokering and it was working, and I'm very, very happy. The top land at the signing board, so it was working.
How does this day compare with other days in your X-Alps history? Is this, would you say this is like one of your...
Nah, that's the absolute... because the morning was not so nice, it was raining, and the forecast to fly was not so good. And I thought it's, maybe Davos. And there is also a Silvretta group, which is difficult to pass. And I was almost able to fly, but I need to walk a bit. Then landed in Davos and was quite happy. So what I can do next is just a surprise. And that the day is so good with this high base, it's... It's a magic day.
Yeah. So you've been on the go since 5 o'clock in the morning. You look quite tired. I mean, can you give a feeling of you know your body? I mean, you must be exhausted. You must be pretty knackered.
Yeah. You know, it's this point here. It's the very difficult one. And normally, if you climb here, it needs 3-4 hours from the bottom. And top land normally, it's not possible on top. So you have to walk for sure. And I landed here and it's just amazing.
Yeah. So can you just tell me what you're up to now? What's the plan?
I was checking the rain radar. We could see that it comes at the landing in Meiringen. It looks that it's gonna rain in the next 30 minutes. So I think about waiting a bit more to have no risk in the landing. And I think about the next steps towards Eiger. I'm discussing with my team what to do, because anyway I will wait, because the airspace is closed until 6:30 or 6:15.
Oh really?
So it's another 10 minutes closed.
Okay.
And so it's a tactic game now.
Okay.
Not pushing too much and looking step by step.
Brilliant. Well, it's amazing how well you've been doing. I'm just going to grab the phone because people have probably got comments and questions, but you crack on. You just don't let me interfere with what you're up to. So, what a joy to catch up with Chrigel. I'm just going to show you the view outside while we're here. So let's turn it around. Have we got any more comments? Ah, look at the view there. Oh, can I just take that over there? Just want to adjust the exposure. I changed the exposure there just so that we could see. There we go, there we are. That's better. Look at that view. Now that, down there, is a very long hike if you're not able to top land here. So this could be a real dividing line in the race between the leaders who are able to land, or anyone who's able to land, and those who have to hike. And let's nip over to the other side, just because it's just so amazing. It's just an incredible view. Look at it over here. So Moses, it's us for Moses. Can we have a guided little tour over here of these mountains? So where's the Eiger?
In this direction. You don't see it. okay. From this direction inside.
And do you know the names of?
No.
I'm sorry to put you on
actually,
the spot.
Actually, the
Sustenhorn is over there, the big one.
There's a Sustenhorn.
Sustenhorn. Right is Gwechtenhorn.
Yeah.
And then what you can see over there is towards Grimsel. Behind is already Wallis. And if Chrigel wants to go to Bernese Alps, then he has to cross here on the south face of this chain.
Yeah.
And there you see the backside of Eiger. You see First, and there is the big Scheideck.
Okay.
Right, straight forward there.
Brilliant.
Behind this Grindelwald.
Good. And your qualifications, sir? What's your, are you local to this area? Are you just following the race?
No, just from the area.
Just
here.
From the area. Brilliant. Thank you. So, yeah, so we've got a little bit of a guided tour. May not have heard everything just because the wind's blowing a little bit. So apologies if we cut out there, but you can see the view. I mean, it's that direction. And, yeah, all I can think about is what a great place to spend the night. So I'm going to stay the night up here and soak up the view. What a day it's been. Another epic day in the Red Bull X-Alps. But of course, remember, it's not just about Chrigel. There are 30 other athletes. I forgot for a moment that Rodolf Ackel was eliminated this morning. 30 other athletes out there battling away, each and every one of them having their own ups and downs, epic moments, struggles, battles in the air and on the ground. So stay tuned, send them lots of love as well. And we look forward to catching up whenever next I go live. I think that's a wrap for me. Thanks, and I'll leave it with this. There he is. There he is. There's that. There he is.